Hi, everyone. I hope you're enjoying your time with us today at Google I/O. Welcome to this technical session, where you'll learn how Google Assistant's architecture powers voice features in your apps. I'm Rebecca Nathenson, and I head up the product management team for the Google Assistant Integrations and Developer Platform. It always amazes me how deep the technology is behind making Assistant work. I think for a lot of us who grew up with some kind of sci-fi voice-powered assistant on TV, whether that's Jarvis or the Star Trek computer or any other type of magical voice interface, it's easy for us to gloss over just how hard getting this right really is. I know when I joined Assistant in 2020, I was amazed at the depth of thought, design, and tech that went into a simple utterance like book a table for 4 at 8. And when we add in the ability to understand what kinds of actions apps can take and let the assistant connect users with those actions wherever it makes the most sense, it feels like magic. But it's magic that is backed by so much tech. Today, we're going to walk through an overview of Assistant's architecture and what goes into enabling voice interactivity on so many devices across the world. After that, we'll review ways developers can plug into Assistant to take advantage of voice-forward APIs.
Thanks, Rebecca. I'm Alec Truitt, and I work on global product partnerships for Google Assistant. My team works with partners to explore new Assistant platform features and create exciting experiences for their users. Before we dive into Assistant's architecture, I'll share a brief background of Google Assistant and our vision for where we're headed. Back in 2016, we first introduced Google Assistant because we wanted to help users get things done. We knew that enabling users to engage with Google Assistant for what they wanted by asking questions as a natural conversation like, "Hey Google, what's the weather?" was the best way to achieve this new, frictionless, helpful, and personal experience. Since then, Google Assistant has grown as a conversational agent available in over 30 languages, 90 countries, and on more than 1 billion devices. Whether the user is on their phone, in the car on the go, or at home, we are developing assistant experiences that seamlessly span across the user's many devices and contexts throughout the day. Our goal is to enable cohesive, helpful, and inclusive user journeys informed by feedback from developers like you by developing healthy ecosystems to support these experiences. Users don't just want a more natural way to get what they need, they want to get more of what they need in that natural way. Google Assistant is natural in that users can just say what they want, and it's not tied to a single device or service. We build Assistant leveraging the latest advances in machine learning, AI, and natural language understanding, along with Google's technology stack, to create an advanced assistive experience. Our developers play a crucial part in how we can deliver on those millions of interests from users, such as asking Assistant, "Hey Google, when is my Walmart order arriving?" to check the status of an order. Assistant is evolving to become a conversational agent that helps users get things done with their favorite apps and devices. We've seen that users want a more seamless voice experience and the opportunity to switch back and forth between voice and other modalities such as touch. We're excited to share the new scalable assistant integration paths to enable these voice-forward experiences for users. Next, let's explore the components of Google Assistant's architecture that bring these conversational assistive experiences to life and how you as the developer can plug into these common development and testing tools to build on this infrastructure. Let's take a look at an example my family knows all too well. Planning our weekly grocery order. Assistant can now string together many segments of this journey, such as looking at items we order most often, adding them to cart, and placing the order. Then I can simply ask Assistant, "Hey Google, book a time with Walmart to schedule our grocery pickup." When a user makes a request to Assistant, there are three important steps that happen in the background to quickly fulfill it. Assistant receives the user's request, processes it to understand the best action to take, and finally fulfills the user's request. When a user makes the request such as, "Hey Google, book a time with Walmart," Google breaks out the parameters of the query, and then Google's natural language understanding, also known as NLU, plays a key role in matching it to the user's intent, while also factoring in the user's context and device type. We think of Assistant as having a few superpowers that can create value for users and developers. Google's NLU is a great example of this, and another very important one is called actionability. This is the idea that Assistant can understand and operate with a set of intents any given app supports. The final step to fulfill this request is to deep link the user into the Walmart app to reserve a pickup order time. Assistant does this by understanding what capabilities apps support and which apps can best fulfill the user's request. By integrating with Assistant, your app can leverage Google's infrastructure to power these voice-forward experiences for your users. Now that we've covered the process at a high level, I'm going to hand it over to Luyan to review the special components of Google's architecture, like our evolving NLU capabilities, in more detail.
Thank you, Alec, for introducing the Assistant's overall architecture. I'm Luyan Chi, a software engineer working on Google Assistant. My team works on building the platform for developers to integrate with Google Assistant. Now let's dig more into Google's superpower. That's a part that really makes your voice integration even better. A key ingredient of Assistant is the capability to transcribe speech into text. That's what we call speech recognition. When a user issues a voice query to Assistant, the targeted device with Assistant support will open a streaming connection with the backend server, which receives audio data and converts speech to text. We don't simply transcribe one word by another. In the middle of a dialogue, Google Assistant biases its results to listen for what is expected, such as a yes or no answer, just as a person might. It also uses information such as the contact names to improve transcriptions. This is called speech biasing. With this, Assistant is able to transcribe voice into text accurately. After the speech recognition step, the Assistant platform will convert the user query text into an interpretation, which is a formal description of what the user wants, with the intent and arguments rewritten into a structured format. As Alec mentioned earlier, this is called Natural Language Understanding, NLU. Understanding intent is not a simple task. For example, if a user's response to a question is yes, that is pretty straightforward. But what about all the variations of yes? Like, that works. Sure. Why not? I agree. Go ahead. And so much more. Google Assistant NLU could understand different variations of users' input. Let's look at another example of natural language understanding. The user might ask Assistant to book a table for four at Bill's restaurant for tomorrow night at 8. As you can see, there are two numbers in the query, 4 and 8. The Assistant NLU is able to understand that 4 means 4 people, and tomorrow night at 8 is a specific date and time. Assistant NLU is also able to take context into consideration. For example, if a user asks, "How is the weather in Mountain View?" After getting a response, the user issues a follow-up query, "How about New York?" In this case, even though the second query doesn't mention weather, Assistant is able to understand from the context that the user is asking about weather and will be able to respond correctly. What's more challenging is this. Users talk to Assistant in a natural way, which sometimes include multiple back and forth between user and Google Assistant. That's what we call a dialogue. For example, if the user asks the Assistant to book a table for four at Bill's restaurant without saying when, the Assistant replies with, "When do you want the table?" or something similar. The user can then say, "Tomorrow night at 8. The dialogue continues until the Assistant has enough information to complete the request, at which point the Assistant summarizes the request, asks for confirmation, takes action, and confirms completion. As you can see from these examples, natural language understanding is a complex task. There are many different variations to express one intent. users prefer to speak with assistant in a natural and conversational way. When understanding the user intent, we can't simply look into a single user query, but need to take context into consideration and be able to support multi-turn dialogue. Now to mention that complexity to handle internalization. Luckily, Assistant could do the heavy lifting for you. By integrating with Google Assistant, your apps can leverage the powerful and evolving NLU capabilities provided by Google. Next, George will share more about how your apps could integrate with Google Assistant.
Thanks, Luyan. I'm George Nabaa, and I lead the partner engineering team working with Google's top partners on Assistant. Let's look at how you can take advantage of this infrastructure based on some common scenarios. Depending on the type of app that you want to voiceify, Google Assistant can help. If you're a hardware developer, check out our Smart Home SDK. And if you want to create custom experiences, look into conversational actions. But for this session, we will focus on how Android developers can take advantage of Google's NLU infrastructure. App Actions is the framework that enables you to voiceify your Android apps. With App Actions, users say simple voice commands to quickly access your app's functionality using Google Assistant's intent mapping and NLU. To implement App Actions, you need to do two things. One, specify which user intents your app supports. And two, specify how your app can fulfill these intents. The first step is to let Google know which user intents or capabilities your app can fulfill. To do this, you either leverage one of Google's built-in intents, BII for short, or create your own custom intents. Built-in intents model some of the common ways that users express tasks they're trying to do or information they seek, such as ordering a meal, booking a ride, or checking an account balance. The great thing about BIIs is that Google builds and maintains the language models required to understand a wide variety of terms that relate to that particular intent, meaning you don't have to. We now support 66 built-in intents across many verticals, such as fitness, finance, food ordering, and more. The second step is to let Google know how your app can fulfill the user's intent. This is done through an Android intent that contains all of the extracted parameters from the BII. Now that we understand the basics of intent and fulfillment, let's look at how we implement them in practice. In order to enable App Actions in your Android app, you declare a capability tag in shortcuts.xml. Capabilities tell Google what user intents your app supports. Next, the intent tag contains the instructions that tell Google how to build the Android intent that specifies how your app can fulfill the user's query. Intent tags also contain any parameters that you want Assistant to extract from the query. By default, Assistant sends BII parameters extracted from the user query to your app as extra data of the Android intent. For example, for a user query like, "Hey Google, start my run on example app," the app receives an intent that invokes the component, target package, and target class. And the component receives an extra with the key value pair, exercise, and run. And here's how you access the extracted BII parameters. Once you have a capability defined, you can extend the functionality of that capability with static shortcuts. You can think of static shortcuts as an instance of a capability with some of its parameters having predefined values. This is especially helpful if you find yourself having to handle requests that are variations on a theme. For example, Fulfilling the start BII intent requires your request matching logic to handle variations like jog, sprint, or race. This logic quickly becomes cumbersome as supported workouts increase. You avoid this complex matching logic by using an inline inventory, which is a set of static Android shortcuts defined in shortcuts.xml. Each shortcut contains an item identifier and a list of synonyms representing variations in how users might refer to the item. During invocation, the BII compares the user-provided BII parameter to the synonym list. When a match is found, the BII parameter is updated to the matching shortcuts item identifier. In this sample, the inline inventory shortcut declares a parameter binding tag within a capability binding element, binding it to the exercise.name BII parameter defined in the capability. And here's the string resource at array run names that specifies a list of synonyms that assistant will recognize and map to the cardio run item ID. Note that static shortcuts are ingested by assistant when you upload a release to the Google Play console. Since static shortcuts can only be created and updated with new releases, they are most useful to highlight common activities and content in your app. Assistant performs the natural language understanding on the query matching the semantics of the request to the predefined pattern of a BII or custom intent you defined. Then, Assistant generates an Android intent to launch the in-app destination of the request using information you provided in the capability and shortcuts tags. And finally, Assistant fulfills the user request by launching the generated Android intent and its resolved parameters. At this I/O, we're announcing a slew of new features that further enhance the benefits of the App Actions platform. First, Brandless Queries now allow Assistant to fulfill user requests through your app, even when your app is not explicitly named. We are also announcing App Install Suggestions, where Assistant can automatically direct user to the Play Store listing to encourage them to install your app if a user triggers the proper Assistant query for the functionality of your app when it's not installed. With smarter custom intents, we've improved the machine learning grammar expansion that triggers your app, meaning you don't have to manually model as many query patterns. And finally, we are enabling shortcuts to more Android surfaces like Auto and Wear OS. For more details, please watch the Assistant Across Devices and Assistant on Auto talks to learn more. With this, I will pass it to Rebecca to recap.
Thanks, George. Google is working hard to make Assistant the best way for users to get things done with their favorite apps and devices. We've seen that users want voice to work more seamlessly. Google's investment in machine learning and NLU can be leveraged by developers with App Actions. And to learn more about how you can harness Google's NLU, check out our other Assistant sessions like Car Talk, Assistant for Android Auto, which goes into how Assistant supports Android app content on Android Auto. You can also learn about an overview of the capabilities available to app developers across a huge variety of device types at Google Assistant functionality across Android devices. And finally, for hands-on learning, check out our workshop, where you'll learn how to integrate your Android widgets with Google Assistant with App Actions. Check out these additional resources to get started today. And don't forget to follow us on Twitter or sign up for the developer newsletter. On behalf of Alec, Luyan, and George, thank you.